Young people are not apathetic. Angry, maybe. Confused, perhaps, but not apathetic. They are, however, a hugely atomised and fragmented group of people in many ways. And one of the key reasons for this is the current employment climate under capitalism. It is difficult for young people to form economic and workplace solidarity, particularly through traditional structures like unions. The reason for this is regarding the many changes that we've seen to employment under neoliberalism since the 1980s. Further to this, in 2016, it was estimated that in the UK, over 6 million people were in precarious or insecure employment. Precarious and insecure employment not only makes it difficult to buy a house, start a life, it also means it makes it far more difficult to be able to challenge these structures of inequalities within the workplace. The current employment and working conditions facing young people today gives rise to what the neo-Marxist political thinker Nikos Palantzis described as the isolation effect. The isolation effect is essentially whereby neoliberal markets are able to place young people in competition with each other for a very limited amount of jobs. As young people struggle to make ends meet, they are also distinctly aware that any forms of resistance or discontent they might express in the workplace could lead to them losing their jobs, with many other unemployed people ready to take their place. All of this leaves young people with very weak individual bargaining power and has a huge impact on their ability to make change for the better. Whilst it may be difficult for young people to form economic or workplace solidarity, what the protest movements of 2011 have demonstrated is that young people are looking and seeking to form solidarity at the political level. It was argued by many people that young people made up the core of many of the protest movements of 2011. Young people are looking for ways to address inequality, to bring about positive change, and are backing those that claim they will do this. A key example of this would be through the Momentum movement and the huge amount of backing that Jeremy Corbyn has had. Protest movements such as Occupy demonstrate the willingness and want of young people to enact positive political social change.
Get more from the Open University. Check out the links on screen now.